One of the most mysterious things about COVID is its ability to turn a person's immune system against itself, calling what is called cytokine storm.
The key to saving lives from that storm may be in a clinical trial launching at Washington University School of Medicine here in St. Louis. I spoke with the doctor in charge of it. Most people can recover from COVID, but others continue to fight the virus even after it has cleared the body.
What we're seeing with COVID is that people who get progressively sicker, who end up in hospital with pneumonia, who end up in hospital needing oxygen because they're short of breath, they have a bad cough, those folks are getting it not because there's too much virus, but because their immune system has overreacted.
The body produces cytokines as an immune response, but when it produces too many of them, it causes a cytokine storm. The result is damage to the lungs, multiple organ failure, and death. Washington University School of Medicine is working with the National Institutes of Health on a new phase 3 clinical trial to see if a combination of drugs will help stop the cytokine storm.
Will that actually improve the person's ability to recover from the pneumonia and potentially survive the infection?
They are drugs that are already used to curb the immune system and reduce inflammation.
These are drugs that have been studied. We know their safety profile, so it's not quite as experimental as something that's completely new.
About 60 centers across the country will take part in the clinical trial. People with the virus will still get the standard treatment of remdesivir or plasma therapy.
It is absolutely true that people who get sick with this virus now have a better chance of surviving than they would have had back at the beginning of the epidemic. But we still see people with progressive disease, and we still unfortunately see people dying every day in the United States